So friends, here we start with the meningitis. Now the basic terms is itis mean inflammation and inflammation of meninges, that known as meningitis. Now the exact definition of meningitis is what? An acute inflammation of leptomeninges by microorganism or physical and chemical agents is called meningitis. Okay, due to some leptomeninges, inflammation occur due to some microorganisms or any physical or chemical agents that produce the inflammatory reaction. Okay, that is what the exact definition of meningitis. Here in this diagram, the brain tissues is present and the three layers like pyometer, the arachnoid wad and the dura mater, that are meninges, and the skull layer. Now, the types of meningitis is different meningitis, like first one is what about the bacterial meningitis, then viral meningitis, the tuberculous meningitis, fungal meningitis, and the last type is about the chemical meningitis. Now first we start with the bacterial meningitis. So basically the name suggests meningitis, that is what inflammation of meningitis, and it caused by the bacteria. So the definition exact is acute or chronic inflammation of meninges by pyogenic organism. Pyo means pus formation, and it is known as bacterial meningitis. Okay, so inflammation occurred due to some bacterial organism, that is what about the bacteria meningitis. Now here, brain structure, skull, and the spinal cord. But second diagram show the advanced bacterial meningitis, that is if the bacteria enter and it cause the inflammation, so that is shown in this diagram, and spinal cord is also infected with the bacteria. So it is the diagram of brain and spinal cord with the bacterial meningitis. Now we discuss the pathology, exact pathology behind this. So usually it occurs due to secondary to bacteremic illness. Okay, if bacteria enter into the blood and it cause the illness, so that is secondary invasion. But if it spread directly by the infection in the ears, skull fracture in accident or sinus, or can be airborne infection, that are the direct route for the spreading of bacteria, and that also produce the meningitis. So if the bacteria entered, pyoarachnoid is congested and infiltrated with the inflammatory cells. So what happened is congestion of pyo and arachnoid matter is occur, and inflammatory reaction is start whenever the pathogen enter into the body. So thin layer of pus formation is occur and organized to form adhesion between the layers. So ena karane shu thase, obstruction of the flow of cerebrospinal fluid, that is what about the CSF, and ultimately lead to hydrocephalus, that is pressure is increased and or damage to the cranial or the base of the brain. So ultimately, if CSF rise, so protein content is increased due to infection and cellular reaction starts, and it cause what? Arteritis, that is inflammation and obstruction in the leptomeningeal arteries, and ultimately it start produce the secondary cerebral infarction. So this is what about the exact pathology behind the bacterial meningitis. Now we discuss about the causative organisms. Now name suggests that due to bacteria it might happen. So some bacteria like gram-negative bacilli, that is E. coli or Proteus, then group B streptococci bacteria, H. influenza, Streptococcus pneumoniae, and Neisseria meningitis. So these are the causative organisms. The others etiology, it might like extreme of age, then such patient who are immunocompromised patient like AIDS, that diabetes, that these are the comorbid conditions responsible for the bacterial meningitis. Then long-term steroid use and taking immunosuppressant drug. Then other causes are alcoholism, that is excessive alcohol consumption, then insanitation, poverty, and the overcrowding people. These are etiology responsible for the infection of the bacteria. Now we move toward the clinical features. So first we understand these all diagrams. So the first is fever and cold, hands and feet. Okay, patients suffer from the high fever and with the hand and feet coldness. Then second is excessive vomiting, severe headache, stiff neck, deformity. Then dislike of bright lights. Okay, patient ne bright lights thi problem thase. Then joint or muscle pain, drowsy or difficult to wake, and confusion. So these are some main clinical features. The others are fever, rigors, that is stiffness thai jase, toxemia, headache, nausea, vomiting, hypertension, bradycardia, decreased heart rate and deterioration of the consciousness and confusion in the patient. The other clinical features are neck rigidity. Okay, that is what about the neck stiffness. Then positive Koenig sign. Now, how we diagnose the Koenig sign? So first of all, so karvanu patient assume the 90 degree positions. Okay, and you have to try to extend that leg, okay, extend that knee. So if meningitis is present, what happen? Restriction occur in the straighten to the leg. Okay, jare leg straight karva jasu, extension karva jasu, so we have feel restriction because of the hamstring tightness. So that is known as the positive Koenig sign, that shows the patient is suffer from the meningitis. Then other clinical features is photophobia, then cranial no pulses because of the brain structure involvement. Okay, due to increased CSF and that lead to the some structural damage. So cranial no pulses commonly affect the 3rd, 4th, then 6th and 7th cranial no pulses. Then neurological deficits like the nystagmus, then aphasia, then the ataxia. Okay, so this type of neurological deficits also present. Other clinical features that are partial or generalized seizures might happen to the patient. Then purpura or petechy, basically it happened due to the blood vessels rupture, and in that what happened, the purple colored dots which is present on the skin, that is purpura, that is in this diagram. Then lethargy, that is patient feel fatigue after some work. Then poor appetite, okay, problem in the eating. Okay, so patient ne bhook ochi lagse. Then restlessness and the diarrhea. So these are the clinical features related with the bacterial meningitis. Now we further see about the investigations. So what we have to investigate first is examination of CSF, that is cerebrospinal fluid. If we examine that, what it shows, it shows the raised WBC count. Why? Because of the infection, and mainly in WBC the neutrophil is increased, that is 100 to 16,000 cells per microliter. The second is reduced CSF glucose, and third is raised CSF protein due to infection. So this is what the exact difference in CSF with the patient of bacterial meningitis. Then if we do the blood culture, so what it shows, it so latex agglutination bacterial antigen test we have to do. Then polymerase chain reaction kari sakye, that used to analyze the bacterial DNA. And lastly we investigate by the CT scan. Now is management. So first we discuss the medical management of each. So first it is the bacterial meningitis, so we start the antibiotic therapy. So in that, some drugs like the ampicillin, the third generation of cephalosporin, and vancomycin. These drugs are basically antibiotics which start earlier to the patient. And other is corticosteroid, that is dexamethasone for 48 hours. Now prevention is better than cure. So what is the prevention is, immunization and vaccine is used are conjugate vaccine for HIP, that is what, Haemophilus influenza type B. Okay, so ena mate apne vaccine aapi sakye chhe. Then conjugate polysaccharide vaccine against group C meningococcus and pneumococcal vaccine also give to the patient. Other is by chemoprophylaxis drug. Okay, say koi drug apne aapi sakye jenathi prevent kari sakye, so that are rifampicin and the ciprofloxacin. Now the second type of meningitis, that is what about the tuberculous meningitis. So introduction of this, it is common in developing countries. Okay, then so basically India it is happened, then seen as it is secondary infection. Okay, like TB thai hoy patient ne to ena thi thai sake chhe due to tuberculous bacteria. So it tuberculous meningitis occur as secondary to tuberculosis of the chest. Pathology of behind this, it what, metastatic foci of primary infection lodge in meninges, cerebral or spinal tissues and choroid plexus. Okay, so ena andar su hase infection primarily present chhe. At this place metastatic foci su thai jese rupture thai jese ane su thase spread thase, and it cause infection, exudation which obstruct the basal cistani and result in hydrocephalus. And third is vasculitis, and it cause infarction of brain and the spinal cord. Now, etiology of this tuberculous meningitis is age. So, age is what? High incidence from 6 months to 3 years. Then, gender, equal incidence for both, that is equal in male and female. Then, primary infection in lungs. Okay, TB na je bacteria che. Okay, to age hun thase primary infect karse lungs ne or mediastinal glands or bowel or mesenteric glands. Then, what it happen? This bacteria go into the bloodstream and produce the caseous foci in brain, meninges and spinal cord. Pachi dhime dhime brain affect thase, meninges affect thase and spinal cord involved thase. And when this focus is ruptured in the CSF, it cause what? Meningitis. That is inflammation of the meninges. So, clinical features basically, first is prodermal stage of sensory irritability thase patient mein. Onset ke was insidious, change in temperament, then irritability thase patient ne restlessness feel thase, there is no interest in playing and patient remaining drowsy state. Then anorexia and vomiting, constipation, temperature is normal or either raised because of infection, and this stage lasts for weeks or more. Okay. Then second stage also jara disease progress thase, that is what the stage of meningeal irritation. So in that what happened, the patient suffer from the convulsion or seizure, then child lies curled up upon side, stiff of neck and positive Kernig's or Brudski signs. Okay, this is what the Kernig sign I explained. Now we discuss about the Brudski sign. Diagram of the Brudski sign, what happened in that, on flexing the neck there is flexion of hip and knees. Okay, so that is positive. Chare patient nu neck flexion karso apne passively, so ultimately with that the flexion of hip and knees occur, and whenever you try to flex one leg, automatically the another leg is also flexed. So that is what about the positive Brudski sign. Then another features are tense anterior frontanella and separation of cranial sutures giving cracked spot resonance on tapping skull. Okay, jyare apne skull par tap karsu, so like cracked sound is here, that is what cracked pot, and that also known as McQueen's sign. Then grinding of teeth, then muscular twitching and squint is present. Temperature which is raised up to 101 to 102 degree Fahrenheit, disturbance of consciousness, then this is what about the second stage features. And the last stage is terminal stage of coma. In that what happened, irritability replaced by coma and dilated pupils of the patient like hydrocephalus. Okay, and rapid loss of weight and dehydration is occur. Then tachycardia and irregular pulse, respiration is irregular and often Chinese stock breathing is occur. Okay, that Chinese stock breathing is followed by apnea. Okay. Then tremor and sometimes choric movement. Okay, like in chorea patient the movement is happen. Okay, that type of movement is present in this patient. May have decerebrate rigidity, then may have optic nerve compression due to cranial nerve damage and the papilloedema. So these all are about the clinical features. So just we revise, okay, in tuberculous meningitis we categorize the clinical features in 3 stage. So the first stage is about the prodromal stage, that in that sensory irritability occurs. So the symptoms are irritability, restlessness, periods of drowsiness, etc., anorexia, constipation. The second stage is what about the meningeal irritation stage, in that convulsion, then stiffness of neck, the positive Kernig's and Brudski signs and the McQueen sign. Then patient to do the grinding of teeth, muscle twitching and squint. Temperature is highly increased. Now the third stage is terminal stage of coma. In that patient is replaced by coma or dilated pupils, weight loss thase, dehydration, tremor is present like choric patient, decerebrate rigidity, tachycardia, and lastly what, the papilloedema. So these are what about the all clinical features related to the tubercular meningitis. Now the investigations are CSF examination. So what shows that CSF trace are increased. Spider web or cobweb appearance may be seen when allowed to stand. Then sugar level is reduced below 50 milligram or per 100 ml, and it shows the acid fast bacilli in the fluid. Other investigations are CT scan or MRI, which used to detect the hydrocephalus and basal meningeal thickening. The other test for the diagnosis of the TB bacteria, that is to find TB antibody, we use the ELISA method and the PCR, that is what, polymerase chain reaction analysis. Now the last is management, that is about medical management. So the most important drug used is streptomycin, isoniazid and rifampicin. Or other drugs are combination of pyrazinamide plus streptomycin, then isoniazid, rifampicin for first 2 months we can use. Then other steroids that are dexamethasone or prednisolone, and it helps to rapid improvement of general condition of patient, and it reduce the inflammatory condition and further damage to the brain. Symptomatic treatment we can give for convulsion, we can give the anticonvulsant drug like phenobarbital or diazepam. Then increase intracranial pressure thai give hai patient ne. और इरिटेबिलिटी होती है तो वी कैन डू द लंबर पंचर और द ड्रग मैनिटोल, एसिटाजोलामाइड और डेक्सामेथासोन वी कैन गिव सो दैट मेंटेन द प्रेशर, इंट्राक्रैनियल प्रेशर. एंड फॉर फीवर वी कैन यूज द पैरासिटामोल और आइस कंप्रेस. फॉर कॉन्स्टिपेशन वी कैन यूज द स्टूल सॉफ्टनर लाइक ग्लिसरीन सपोजिटरी और ग्लिसरीन सिरिंज. एंड फॉर डिहाइड्रेशन वी कैन यूज द ग्लूकोज सलाइन सो दैट मेंटेन द एडिक्वेट water in the body. So this is what about the management of tuberculosis meningitis. Now the third is viral meningitis. So name suggests viral meningitis means what, due to virus infection. So introduction, commonly it is caused by viral infection and it is less serious than the bacterial or pyogenic meningitis. Okay, so it is less severe and it not damage so much. So it caused by the some organism like enterovirus, mumps virus, herpes simplex virus, Epstein-Barr virus. Now pathology behind this. So virus enter in body through respiratory tract or the gastrointestinal tract or the genitourinary tract or inoculation through the skin. Okay, so a route che ke virus a rite enter thai sake che body ma. And then what happened, the travels through the peripheral nerve or overcome reticuloendothelial defense system, and ultimately it react on the central nervous system, that is CNS. And if resides the meninges, okay, meninges to the pouches, so it cause the inflammation and ultimately lead to viral meningitis. Clinical features, fever, malaise, common jo viral infection thai, ena jo features hoy, a type na jova marse. So fever, malaise, that is thak lagse patient ne, sore throat, the headache is common, then photophobia, the drowsiness, mild meningism, neck stiffness and the skin rashes present. Investigations are CSF examination. Okay, have badu common thai jase baddama. So CSF examination what shows, the cell count elevated, mainly lymphocyte or monocyte, and glucose level and protein level are normal in that. But in bacterial meningitis the protein level is increased, remember that. Other tests are PCR, polymerase chain reaction, and detect the viral DNA or RNA. And other is culture of throat swabs because of the throat infection is also present and sore throat is occur. So culture of throat swabs or stool to detect the virus. Last is treatment. So there is no specific treatment is required. Just only quiet environment should be provided to the patient, and basically recovery occur within the 7 to 14 days, and it is benign and self-limiting disease. So we have to give the specific treatment for that. Now this is what about the all types no differentiation karu chhe CSF ma. So CSF indices in meningitis is what, first column show about the normal mechanism. If you take CSF of the normal patient, then second is patient suffer from bacterial meningitis, then viral meningitis and tuberculosis meningitis. Now first is pressure. So if we take CSF, so pressure in the normal individual, that shows the normal. And if in bacterial meningitis, either it is normal or increase. Same like in viral meningitis, pressure is either increase or maybe normal. and same in the tuberculosis. Second is color of CSF. So clear in normal patients, then in bacterial it is cloudy, okay. In viral meningitis also it is clear, and in tuberculosis maybe it is clear or either cloudy. Red cell count, that is 0 to 4 per mm cube, that is the normal value. Then in bacterial meningitis this is normal, viral mapan normal, and tuberculosis mapan normal resin. But white cell count is differentiated because of the infection. So the normal is 0 to 4 per mm cube. So in bacterial meningitis it is up to 1000 to 5000 polymorph. In viral meningitis the lymphocyte value is 10 to 2000, and in lymphocyte in tuberculosis meningitis that is 50 to 500. So this is what about the differentiation of the CSF. Other is glucose. Now glucose normal value is the less than 60% of the blood level. So in bacterial meningitis this value is decreased, in viral meningitis it is normal, and in tuberculosis it is also decreased. Then protein level, that is the more than 0.45 gram per liter, but that is normal value. In bacterial meningitis protein value is high, okay, I will tell you. Then in viral meningitis it is normal, and in tuberculosis it might be normal or might be increased. Then microbiology, so normally sterile, and in bacterial meningitis we do the gram staining. Then in viral meningitis this is sterile or virus might be detected, and in last is tuberculosis, so tuberculosis culture is positive. Now the last is what our physiotherapy management. So it is also important in exam, write down about the meningitis and physiotherapy management for the same. So the goals is what? First is integration of sensory information is promoted, develop ability to maintain posture against gravity, to gain selective voluntary movement pattern in functional activity, to improve balance of the patient, and improve cognitive and psychosocial response, because patient in the conscious drowsy state. Okay, so these are the basic aims of physiotherapy management. Now first is what? Promote integration of sensory information. Okay, so kaya kaya sensory information apne promote kar sakte, like cutaneous sensation, proprioceptive mechanism, auditory and visual input we can use, and we increase the sensory information by this techniques. Now second aim is develop ability to maintain posture against gravity. So what we have to do is stretching, and what જે સ્ટ્રક્ચર જે છે ટાઈટ થઈ ગયા છે એનું સ્ટ્રેચિંગ કરાવી શકીએ છીએ આપણે, લાઈક હેમસ્ટ્રિંગ ટાઈટનેસ છે તો આપણે એના માટે સ્ટ્રેચિંગ કરાવી શકીએ છીએ. સો દેટ વોટ ડુ ઇટ ઇમ્પ્રુવ ધી ફ્લેક્સિબિલિટી ઓફ ધેટ, ઓકે, એન્ડ ઇટ વેરિયસ ફીડબેક મિકેનિઝમ લાઈક મિરર, ઓકે, મિરરની સામે પેશન્ટને આપણે બેસાડી શકીએ છીએ અને એનું પોસ્ચર જે છે કરેક્ટ કરવાનું કરી શકીએ છીએ. સો ઇટ પ્રોવાઈડ વિઝ્યુઅલ ફીડબેક ઓલ્સો, ઓર ફ્લેશ લાઇટ દેટ શાઇન્સ વેન ટાર્ગેટ વર્ટિકલ પોઝિશન ઇઝ અચીવડ. Then joint approximation technique we can use in weight bearing position, so it provide the co-contraction of muscle and it support the joints. Then design a task in which maintenance of vertical positions is necessary, example place small object or book on head such that it should not fall down. એટલે કે આપણે પેશન્ટના હેડ પર કંઈ બુક એવું મૂકી શકીએ છીએ, પેશન્ટ ટ્રાય ટુ બેલેન્સ ધ બોડી, ઓકે, સો એનાથી એનું પોસ્ચર કરેક્ટ થઈ શકે છે. Then third is teach voluntary movement pattern in functional activity. So we have to help to carry out the movement in various functional activity. Then stability and mobility exercise is preferred. So in stability and mobility exercise, like various weight bearing exercise, isometric exercise like scapular stabilization, then creeping, crawling, sitting with elbow extension and weight shifting we can do, kneel standing, standing and shifting weight on both legs, this type of various exercise which improve the balance and the stability, dynamic as well as static. Progress to strengthening exercise with weight cuff to improve strength and endurance of the patient. Last is the to improve balance in various posture, what we can do, balance exercise during static base of support, progress to balance with dynamic. If the patient gains static balance, so we have to further move toward the dynamic base of support. So in that what we can do, reach out activities karavi sakiye chhe on the physio bowl, then stepping up and stepping down stairs, physical exercise, tilting board, throwing and catching ball, this type of activities improve the patient dynamic balance. Then fifth is improve cognitive and psychosocial response. सो रिड्यूस एजिटेटेड एंड एक्जाजरेटेड इमोशनल स्टेट अपने ये थेरापी आपी तो एना शूँ थे पेशेंट जो एक्जाजरेटेड इमोशनल स्टेट है ओछू थे बाय दी हेविंग नॉन थ्रिएटनिंग इंटरेक्शन विथ दी पेशेंट पेशेंट साथ इंटरेक्शन करो एनी प्रॉब्लम ने सांभळो अने एने हेल्प करो देन मेंटेन काम एंड कूल एनवायरमेंट अराउंड दी पेशेंट एंड रेप इन ब्लैंकेट एंड रॉक देम इन स्लो रिदमिकल एंड रिपीटेटिव मैनर सो दिस इज वॉट अबाउट दी मैनेजमेंट फॉर दी कॉग्निटिव एंड साइकोसोशियल रिस्पॉन्सेस देन रिपीटेशन ऑफ एक्टिविटी इफ मेमरी लॉस नहीं थत बैक्टीरियल मेनिंजाइटिस में बट फॉर प्रिवेंशन ऑफ दैट वी कैन डू दिस रिपीटेशन ऑफ एक्टिविटी एजुकेट फैमिली मेंबर्स एंड मेक देम एक्टिवली पार्टिसिपेट इन थेरेपी ऑल्सो देन अलो पेशेंट टू डू एक्टिविटी बाय देमसेल्व्स ओके यू हैव टू जस्ट गिव सम क्यूज एंड टू डेवलप देयर थिंकिंग प्रोसेस एंड मेक देम सेल्फ इंडिपेन्डेंट अपने पेशेंट ने कोईपण एक्टिविटी से जाते अलो करवानी है सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द फिजियोथेरापी मैनेजमेंट ऑफ द मेनिंजाइटिस दैट इज कॉमन फॉर ऑल मेनिंजाइटिस थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग माई वीडियो एंड इफ यू लाइक माई वीडियो प्लीज शेयर विथ योर फ्रेंड्स एंड सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल फॉर मोर वीडियोज़